Guys, welcome back to the channel. And if you're new to the channel, my name is Angela, and today we are watching Wednesday. I am a child of the 80s, which means I grew up in the 90s, which means I grew up with the original Addams Family movies. Not the original series, but the original movies. And I absolutely love and adore every single one of those characters. And I almost didn't want to watch this because I was like, I don't like rebrands. I don't like when they redo things. I don't like when they change people, especially because I like had like a crush on Raul Julia as Gomez. Like he's perfect in every way. Angelica Houston embodies Morticia. Christina Ricci was Wednesday Addams. I love Christopher Lloyd as Fester. I thought he was fantastic. You know, so there's so many of like those actors that like when you think of them, you think of those roles in the Addams Family movies. And I know at some point you gotta let go. I know that you have to let it grow and change, and that's why I'm here, is because I still love this world, I still love these people, and I still want a continuing story of that thing that I grew up with. And I hope it makes me feel the same way that it used to, because I adored Wednesday. I think we all kind of had like, because it was like the grunge era, like emo era, but goth era, like all of us were heading in a direction one way or another with our feelings. And I feel like a lot of girls really dug Wednesday. We're just like, yes, yeah, she's great. The fact that she could be cold and calculated and smart and funny, so funny. Like almost unintentionally funny, but funny nonetheless. So I'm not gonna go into a whole lot. I'm not gonna sit there and tell you how much I miss these characters, because I really do. I really, really miss Raul Julia. May he rest in peace. He was my favorite Gomez. The guy that they've casted for him, I don't really know his name, but I have seen his picture. Not my choice. But, like, I hope he does a great job. I really do. I want all of them to do well. I know that they have a lot of pressure to kind of become these characters now and maybe change who we see in these roles. But I'm just really looking forward to it because it's called Wednesday. So it's about Wednesday. And if my girl is still my girl, I think I'm going to enjoy it nonetheless. All right, guys, let's get into it. I like how it's creepy music panning into a regular high school. There's our girl!
I'm not sure whose twisted idea it was to put hundreds of adolescents in underfunded school run by people whose dreams were crushed years ago.
I mean, yeah.
But I admire the sadism.
I love her humor so much. Aww. Is it Pugsley?
I want names.
Don't know who they were.
I love her.
Best.
Pugsley, emotion equals weakness.
Oh.
Pull yourself together.
I don't know about that. Oh! Did we know that she could do that? I didn't know she could do that.
I'm not about to confess to my brother that I've recently been plagued by vision.
No, she didn't even know she could do that.
I feel like electroshock therapy, but without the satisfying afterburn.
Oh my god.
Wednesday, what are you gonna do?
What I do best.
I don't know what that means, but I'm excited for it because I can only imagine. Is it revenge? Because I hope it's revenge.
The only person who gets to torture my brother is me.
What is that? Is that piranha? Holy shit. I am not upset about this at all, but I mean, I probably should be. Hopefully it was just a little nibble. Oh, this is deliciously twisted. Right to start it out with. Oh, and I forgot. Gwendolyn Christie and Ricky Lindholm. And Christina Ricci. Did I know that? And Catherine Zeta-Jones. Luis Guzman. Okay, that's who is playing Gomez. And I love that Danny Elfman is doing the music because it completely sounds like Danny Elfman. So far, I love everything about this. And I think, I'm like 3 minutes in. gonna love it.
Directed by Tim Burton. Did I know that? I don't even think I knew that. There's so much I didn't know that I thought I knew. Yeah. Gomez and Morticia are just like couples goals.
I promise you, my little viper, you will love Nevermore. Won't she, Tish?
Of course you will. It's the perfect school for her.
Why? Because it was the perfect school for you? I have no interest in following in your footsteps.
Ooh, harsh.
Become the captain of the fencing team, queen of the dark prom, president of the seance society.
I love this school.
Finally, you will be among peers who understand you. Maybe you'll even make some friends.
Yeah.
Nevermore is like no other boarding school. It's a magical place. It's where I met your mother. And we fell in love.
You guys are making me nauseous. Not in a good way.
That boy's family was going to file attempted murder charges. How would that have looked on your record?
Terrible. Everyone would know I failed to get the job done.
That's a way to look at it, I guess. It's funny that they're like so emotional, like the Gomez Morticia love, and then she's very much like, nah.
The trail might look pretty, but it runs right past Nevermore.
My counselor at summer camp was a werewolf.
Oh.
Great guy.
Yeah, they're just like you and me. Until they rip your throat out.
Well, she's fun. Her eyes bug so far out of her face. What is up with this guy? I don't know what just happened there. I mean, he said that, like, he knew a werewolf. Like, is it his old buddy trying to scare him?
At least it's turning into a beautiful day.
I'm not gonna lie, that is beautiful. That's, like, my favorite type of weather. That is a badass-looking school.
Wednesday is certainly a unique name.
Love her.
Her name comes from a line from my favorite nursery rhyme. Wednesday's child is full of woe.
Yeah, that fits.
Did your mother tell you we were roommates back in the day?
Oh, really?
And you graduated with your sanity intact? Impressive.
She's got the burns for her parents.
Larissa, what about Wednesday's therapy session? The court ordered them.
Oh.
School has a relationship with a therapist in Jericho.
We'll see if she survives the first session.
Oh.
I've assigned you to your mother's old dorm, Ophelia Hall.
Oh. Ophelia is the one who kills herself after being driven mad by her family. Correct?
She says it with a knowing smile.
Should we go meet your new roommate?
Yes. Oh, the complete opposite. Okay, I love it.
Howdy, Rumi.
Well, okay.
This is Enid Sinclair.
Are you feeling okay? You look a little pale.
It's just your face.
Welcome to Ophelia Hall.
Hugs, no.
Not a hugger. Got it.
Enid, please take Wednesday to the registrar's office and give her a tour along the way.
The girl's skipping out. She couldn't be more opposite of Wednesday. I love it.
Rumor's been swirling around that you killed a kid at your old school and your parents pulled strings to get you off.
Actually, it was two kids, but who's counting?
Welcome to the quad.
Dare I say cooler than Hogwarts.
But the four main cliques are fangs, furs, stoners, and skinks.
Okay.
Those are the fangs. A.K.A. vampires. That bunch of knuckleheads are furs, A.K.A. werewolves. Like me.
I dig them.
Headphones get pretty loud around here. That's when furs like wolf out. I suggest you pick up some noise-canceling headphones. And that girl, Bianca Barclay, is the closest thing Nevermore has to royalty. She used to date a resident tortured artist, Xavier Thorpe, but they broke up at the beginning of the semester. Reason unknown.
Fascinating.
I know, right?
Enid, you're not gonna believe the dirt I heard about your new roommate. She eats human flesh. You better watch your back.
Quite the contrary. I actually fillet the bodies of my victims, then feed them to my menagerie of pets.
Why don't you boys wait in the car? Wednesday and I need a moment.
Aww.
You're soft and weak. You'll never survive without me. I give you 2 months, tops.
Hug your brother.
I'm gonna miss you too, sis.
Any plans you have of running away end right now.
I will escape this educational penitentiary, and you will never hear from me again.
Oh, I got you a little something. W. M. Our initial. It's made of obsidian, which Aztec priests used to conjure visions.
She already does that. I don't remember Wednesday not liking her family or her parents.
Lurch, the crystal ball, please. Now, we can't talk to you for the first week while you're settling in, so we'll call you next Sunday.
The crystal ball? I love that.
Don't worry, my love. Our little scorpion won't be alone.
I love things so much.
Where's the rest of them?
Well, the torso and arm are over there. We found a leg by the lake, and the rest of the parts are so far unaccounted for. It matches the profile of the other two attacks last week.
What the heck?
Tell them a bear is back.
You don't really believe that, Sheriff?
No, I don't. Whatever did this wasn't human. I know these murders are connected to Nevermore. I just can't prove it yet. So until I can, goddamn bear.
That window is awesome.
What the hell did you do to my room?
Our.
Dividing our room equally. Silence would be appreciated. This is my writing time. I devote an hour a day to my novel. Perhaps if you did the same, your blog might be coherent.
Ow!
Your followers are clearly imbeciles. They respond to your stories with insipid little pictures.
You mean emojis? It's how people express their feelings. You know, I realize that's a foreign concept to you.
Yeah.
When I look at you, the following emojis come to mind. Rope, shovel, hole.
Jesus.
Ah! Don't mess with me. This kitty's got claws and I'm not afraid to use them.
Interesting.
Oh, sorry about the mud.
Wanted to make sure that Wednesday was settling in. I miss Thornhill, your dorm mom.
I love that.
I trust Enid has given you the old Nevermore welcome.
She's been smothering me with hospitality. I hope to return the favor in her sleep.
She's so twisted. I love it.
I try to match the right flower to each of my girls.
A black dahlia.
Oh, you know it.
Of course. It's named after my favorite unsolved murder.
The locals are a tad bit wary about Nevermore. Don't go making any waves or perpetuating any outcast stereotypes.
Yeah, good luck with that.
That means keep your claws to yourself and no smothering people in their sleep. Great talk.
Oh my god, their room is so cool. Everything about this is so cool. Her black outfit. She looks like a ninja. Oh, why you got all those scars, buddy?
Coach, she tripped me.
Maybe if you whined less and practiced more, you wouldn't suck. Seriously, coach, when am I gonna get some real competition?
Right behind you.
You must be the psychopath they let in.
And you must be the self-appointed queen bee. Interesting thing about bees. Pull out their stingers and they drop dead.
Anga!
She's so cool in that outfit. It's funny because when I think Wednesday Adams, I do not think athlete.
Wednesday. The score is even.
For the final point, I would like to invoke a military challenge. No masks, no tips. Winner draws first blood.
Whoa. I don't think they can do that.
It's your decision, Bianca.
She gets to decide that? I feel like that's a lawsuit.
Let's see if you bleed in black and white.
Bold. Okay. did not expect that.
Your face finally got that splash of color it so desperately needed.
I'm kind of happy she lost. I think she needs to be humbled. She's a little too much on her high horse. She's sleeping like a vampire.
I didn't want to be rescued.
So I should have just let that thing smash you to mush?
I would have rather saved myself.
It's good to see you haven't changed. We were 10 and we were bored. Decided to play hide and seek. I had the inspired idea to hide in her casket.
Oh, that's...
I had heard muffled screams. I just figured your godmother had somehow cheated death and was trying to claw her way out.
Either way, you hit the big red stop button and saved me from being flame broiled, so now we're even.
Well, okay. Somebody's checking in on ya.
I knew it. Hello, thing. Surrender? Mother and father sent you to spy on me, didn't they?
She turned the lamp to question him.
The way I see it, you have two options. Option one, I lock you in here for the rest of the semester, and you go slowly insane trying to claw your way out. Option two?
Option two it is. I don't even know what it is.
You pledge your undying loyalty to me.
Aw, he bent the knuckle.
Dr. Kimbert's office is on the second floor. Perhaps afterwards we can visit the weather vane for hot chocolate.
This feeble attempt at bonding is beneath you.
Jesus.
Given your history, I'm sure you're intent on running away. I'm here to prevent that from happening.
I wish you luck.
I don't know. I feel like she's got something hidden up her sleeve.
I read the notes from your school counselor.
Yes, Mrs. Bronson. Ricky!
This is a safe space Wednesday. A sanctuary where we can discuss anything.
I see the world as a place that must be endured. And my personal philosophy is kill or be killed.
So, for instance, when someone bullies your brother, your response is to dump piranha in the pool.
You know the old saying, never bring a knife to a sword fight, unless it's concealed.
I understand you've written 3 novels about a teen girl detective, Viper de la Muerte.
Viper is smart, perceptive, chronically misunderstood.
Sounds like someone we know.
The relationship I found most intriguing was that of Viper and her mother, Dominica. Why don't we dig into that?
There's definitely something broken there.
Nail file.
God. She's going to be out there. Why would she need a nail file to unlock that window when she could have just unlocked that window? What are these visions? Oh!
Holy crap!
Jesus.
Do you make a habit of scaring the hell out of people?
It's more of a hobby. I need a quad over ice. It's an emergency.
All we have is drip.
But drip is for people who hate themselves and know their lives have no real purpose or meaning.
I feel that. I really feel that one.
It doesn't help that the instructions are Italian.
I need a tri-wing screwdriver and a 4mm Allen wrench.
You read Italian?
Obviously.
Of course. It's a native tongue of Machiavelli.
Oh.
You have one of these monsters at home?
Steam-powered guillotine. I built it when I was 10. I wanted to decapitate my dolls more efficiently.
Wow. I adore her. She's just wonderful.
Put that quad in a to-go cup.
But I don't get off for another hour.
I'll sweeten the pot.
$20. Tempting.
Yeah, no doubt.
I can't be bought, so either wait or find someone else to drive you.
I like this kid. Not letting her have her way. I like how it has Miller go realty on the back. The creators. I don't know why I did that. They are the creators. Oh, okay.
This is our booth.
Why are you three just like religious fanatics?
We're pilgrims.
Potato, potato.
We work at Pilgrim World.
where history comes to life.
It takes a special kind of stupid to devote an entire theme park to zealots responsible for mass genocide.
My dad owns Pilgrim World.
Oh, well.
You're calling stupid.
If the buckled shoe fits.
I love her. She's so spicy. I can't believe she's in a fight with pilgrims in a cafe. It's a very odd sentence. Oh. Is Wednesday Addams a superhero? It feels like she's a superhero.
Polish sheriff. This one slipped away from me. Come on, Miss Addams, time to go.
You're an Addams?
Do you know who an Addams are?
Don't tell me Gomez Addams is your father.
Uh-oh.
That man belongs behind bars for murder. Hmm. I'm guessing the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
Not really.
It looks like an accident.
Oh, she saw this.
He's dead. Broke his neck.
Oh. Whoa. I love it. I love it so much. I know I keep saying that, but like, she's just so freaking like cool, twisted, dark, but lovely. They look like Wednesday fighting a pilgrim. Very interesting version of this song.
There's just something wrong about this place. Not just because it's a school.
I think it's kind of cool.
My mom says some wolves are late bloomers, but I've been to the best lichenologist. You know, she says there's a chance I might never.
Hmm.
You know.
I don't know why that seems so sad that she can't turn into a werewolf.
I'd be kicked out of my family pack with no prospect of finding a mate.
I'm failing to see the problem.
Yeah, really. It's her dream.
Why are you crying?
Because I'm upset! Haven't you ever cried? Are you above that too?
I was 6 years old.
She remembers when she cried?
I took my pet scorpion Nero out for his afternoon stroll when we were ambushed.
Pet scorpion?
They wondered what kind of freak would have a scorpion for a pet.
Yeah.
Two of them held me down and made me watch.
Oh, I don't know why I'm feeling sad that the scorpion's gonna die. Somehow they made me feel bad for a scorpion dying.
I cried my little black heart out.
Aww, it's a cool headstone.
But tears don't fix anything.
So I vowed to never do it again. Your secret's safe with me. I still think you're weird as shit, though.
The feeling is incredibly mutual.
I don't think he's accustomed to just seeing a hand walking around. No! Oh! I don't know if that's what I would do if I saw a hand just walking by itself.
Okay, I'm taking orders from a hand. Mm. This isn't weird at all.
It's awesome.
That's thing.
Is he like your pet?
I've always wanted to see Thing do that.
If you're still willing to drive me to the train station, I can make it worth your while.
No charge. Consider it a freebie.
Why?
Yeah.
But I wish I was going with you. At least one of us will get out of this hellhole town.
Hmm. Imagine having the sheriff as your father is rough.
Good luck and safe travels. Still not a hugger. Got it.
She's gonna get that hug by the end of the show.
I wanted you to have this. It's your dad's police file from when he was at Nevermore. I think it's the reason my dad hates him. You okay?
I'm not used to people engaging with me. Mostly me coming in across the street.
You're not scary. You're just kind of...
kooky.
Kooky.
Oh. And mysterious. Oh, no.
Wincing, come on. Wincing.
Rowan, come back.
Rowan has a bad fate awaiting him. Good grief.
I don't have time to explain, but you're in danger.
I think you've got it backwards.
Oh, goodness.
I have to kill you.
The gargoyle. That was you?
Oh, I never would have expected that from him. Yeah, it really is always the quiet ones.
Girl in the picture, that's you. My mother said it was my destiny to stop this girl if she ever came to Nevermore, because she will destroy the school and everyone in it.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, that is terrifying. I love it. Well, is there another girl that looks like Wednesday that turns into that thing? I think that's probably the problem. Yeah, now you gotta stay and figure it out.
So tell us, darling, how was your first week?
Let's see. I narrowly avoided death twice. Mm-hmm. Discovered that my father may be a murderer. Mm. Learned that I could potentially destroy the school. And was mysteriously saved by a homicidal monster. As much as it pains me to admit, you were right, Mother. I think I'm going to love it here.
I love that smile. No, don't show me what's on this season of Wednesday. No, no, no. No, 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 no. Holy crap, what an introduction to Wednesday. What an introduction to this world. Okay, so there's plenty of times where I'm like, I love her. She's everything. She's amazing. She's sometimes a brat. She's sometimes an asshole. She's sometimes not that nice. And I think that that's part of her charm and her appeal, but certainly her words bite. They really do. But I still love her. I really actually like Enid. I like that she's such a stark contrast to Wednesday. But, like, they have a lot in common in the sense that, like, she's afraid she's going to become the thing that Wednesday actually wants to be. And I think Wednesday's afraid to actually feel feelings. And I think they're really good for each other. I totally dig their room. My God. Like, some of these shows, when they show this stuff, like the Hogwarts rooms, the Evermore rooms, just these worlds. I want to live here. I want to be here. I want this to be the place. But Jenna Ortega playing Wednesday is perfection. She's so good. Is she Christina Ricci's? No, but she's exactly her own Wednesday. She doesn't have to be Christina Ricci's Wednesday. And I love that. Like, it's so new and fresh. And although I don't like that she seems to have a disdain for her family, which means that she's not immune to being a teenager. Like, she's a teenage girl. We all hated our parents at that age. Hate's a strong word, but she just really doesn't show that she cares about them. And the fact that she cried about her pet scorpion dying, and that was the last time she remembers crying, that's heartbreaking and sad, especially because her brother, like, obviously has, like a heart, and, like, he's very mushy, and I love that about him. And she finds it to be, like, a weakness and has such disdain for it. And even her parents, I mean, granted, the PDA in front of your kid is a little weird, but, like, I feel like how does Pugsley have the emotions that he does? And Morticia and Gomez love each other and show their emotions the way that they do. And then there's just Wednesday who just, like, wants to be dead to all of it. You know, like, oh, let's dig into that, which I'm sure we're going to. Because, like, I mean, for me, Morticia and Gomez are goals. They're goals. Couples goals. Especially from the movies. Raul Julia. Ooh. Him and Angelica Houston. They were like a power couple. I loved them together. And you know, like I said, like, I don't really know about Luis Guzman. His whole look, the way they have his hair done and his teeth and kind of his mannerisms, it's a little much and distracting. I can't tell you that he's ever going to be Gomez for me. But whatever. If he's in it this much, that's fine. That's fine. Oh, Catherine Zeta-Jones. She looks great as Morticia. Does she capture Morticia? She's a little bit more emotional. She seems to have, like, a little bit more anger brewing, and that's not really something that I think we've ever really seen from any iteration of Morticia. She's normally calm, cool, and collected. And maybe it takes an angsty teenager to piss that woman off. I feel like a 14-year-old girl will absolutely test your mental fortitude. And Gwendolyn Christie, she is just, like, kind of a chameleon, which is not hilarious in the sense of, like, she shouldn't be, but the fact that she's, like, such a tall woman, and she's so big, and, like, she's so dominating, and then she's in this role, and she's very delicate. And I love that. I love that she can play that. And that's just shows you just how talented she is as an actress. Now, I absolutely love that we got Christina Ricci. And in a part that is in no way Wednesday Addams. And I'm happy to see her. It makes me feel like warm and comfortable. And I feel like it's a passing of a torch a little bit because she's in this, but she's not Wednesday. And the Wednesday that is in this is making it her own character. I adore that. There's a lot of elements in here. Like there's a lot of humor and dark humor. And I love that. That's like my jam. And then it just kind of goes a little bit past the line of like comfortability. And I like when humor pushes that boundary, but sometimes it's like, hey. The other thing that I didn't really expect is I didn't expect to see the monster that killed the guy in the beginning. And that was such a Tim Burton face. Like that was like very Beetlejuice like, right? Like just the big eyes and like the shape of the body and how it was moving, just all of it. Like it kind of looked like a werewolf at first, but that was not a werewolf face. And that's unless that's like what werewolves look like in this universe, but that was terrifying. Like I was like, I don't want to look at it, but I can't turn my eyes away. And he's awesome. I can't wait to have like a little figurine of him. I don't even know what that is. It's horrifying and it's going to be wonderful and I'll be so excited to have it. Now with the story and with the school and like the different factions at the school, very excited to see how that plays out and to kind of see their abilities. Bianca seems awful, but awesome at the same time. There's a reason why she's the queen bee at the school. And the fact that she bests Wednesday in like their first fencing match, I don't think that will be the last time we see them fencing against each other. And I'm sure Wednesday will at some point draw blood. But like, I think she's Queen Bee for a reason. Would I like to see her dethroned? I mean, yeah, you always want to see the big dog fall, right? Not for any other reason, not because she beat Wednesday. I mean, she won fair and square. Wednesday called her out, she challenged her, and Bianca won. Now, Rowan says that his mom was a very powerful seer and foresaw Wednesday destroying the school. And here's my argument is like, I don't know if that's Wednesday in that picture. It could just look like her, you know, like there could be somebody else that's Wednesday-ish, but maybe hiding. I don't know. And if it is Wednesday, like, probably she'd take it down for a good reason, especially because it looked like she was fighting a pilgrim. Are pilgrims scary? Like, I don't know. The ones that she's almost fought twice now. I mean, she kicked their ass in that cafe. And that's the other thing is, like, Wednesday is very much like superhero. Like, not only is she having the visions that she's having, which means she's a seer, but also that, like, she's very, I mean, we already know she's incredibly smart, but, like, agile. Not only is she a great fencer, but, like, she knows kung fu from her uncle Fester. Oh, I hope we get to see Fester. That'll be so exciting. I don't know who's playing Fester. I could probably look that up right now. Fred Armisen! Perfect! Oh my god. I can't wait for that. I think I just spoiled that, but, like, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. I'm so excited. There's so many things in this. Like, my mind is racing because there was so much to cover. But even, like, Ricky Lindholm being, like, her therapist. I love Ricky. I think that she is incredibly funny. I'm expecting her to be more Ricky, maybe. I think that there's a reason why she was cast in particular for this. And I hope we get to see that more from her. Especially therapy sessions. Her quirky humor is by far, like, one of my favorite things about her. I'm very drawn to her because of that. Now, Tyler, being the sheriff's son, it seems that he is also drawn to Wednesday. And I don't know in what sense. Like, I don't think he has, like, necessarily a crush on her. He seems intrigued by her, but he also says that, like, he wants to help her, like, gain her freedom. Because he wants his own freedom. I would imagine being a small-town sheriff's son is... It's just... It has to drain all the life and all the fun right out of you. She seems to have, like, a couple boys that are having eyes for her. Because then there's also Ajax that, like, knows her from, is it her grandmother or his grandmother's funeral? I think it was her grandmother's funeral. And he hid in her casket. And Wednesday heard him screaming, so she hit the button to stop the casket from being cremated. Did she really believe that, like, his or her, was it her grandma come back to life? I don't even know now. That part of the story, I wasn't really paying attention as hard because I was just like, he's adorable. Oh my God, they have a history. And then he saved her life. So, wonder where that's gonna go. I don't need teenage love stories in television shows to enjoy them. And if one happens, I'd actually be really interested to see, like, Wednesday, like, not falling in love, but like what that looks like, because I remember from the movies, and like her main goal was, even if she loved this person, was to torture them. So I'm here for it. I'm probably wearing the wrong shirt for this show, right? It's very much against the vibe. It's like bad vibes. Let's just cross that out and put bad right over top of it. Okay, guys, if you want to see the full-length reaction to this episode, it will be available on my Patreon and up to one episode early, as well as other reactions that I'm currently doing, like House of the Dragon, Vox Machina, The Expanse. So remember to like, subscribe, leave me a comment down below if I missed anything in this episode, or... what do you guys think of the cast? Like, what do you think of Luis? And I don't want anyone to shit on anybody, but what do you think of him as Gomez? If it's your first introduction to Gomez, is it just fine? If you were a fan of Raul Julia, how are you feeling about that? If you were a fan of the original Gomez Adams, who I can't even remember his name, but I can see his face clear as day in my head. But, like, you know, like, what do you think of the recasting of certain roles and how they fit? Because there's some that I think seamless, and there's some that I'm like, oh, there's a little hump that I'm going to have to get over. Which, I don't care. I just want more Wednesday. Okay, guys. I'll see ya.